The Kaikōura Canyon was really drastically affected by the 2016 earthquake.
That's a huge scale disturbance. Everything's gone.
One of the largest events recorded anywhere in the world, and that's why we're here. What is the signature of these canyon flushing events, we call them? If we can understand that, that'll be valuable all around the world.
We're looking at geology as well as biology. We want to understand the overall resilience of seafloor communities to these sorts of disturbances. So this is one of the almost unique things about this study, is that we have this clear idea of what was there before. This amazingly rich deep sea ecosystem. This was one of the most productive ever known at that time. 10 weeks after, and everything's gone. Now you've got to start from scratch again.
All the sediment gets cleaned out of a canyon, and then what's left behind is this quite specific geomorphology. These sites that we've been looking at just have, I mean, in this case, these crazy sediment waves just all over them, and we had no idea that that was there. Have you seen that data? Oh, you got to check it out. It's amazing.
This vehicle, you program beforehand, tell it where to go, how deep to go, which sensors to run, and then it does it more or less without guidance on the ship.
We can then go and do something completely different.
What we're trying to measure are just the day-to-day processes that go on. So the nutrients and food that come to the seabed are delivered by currents that operate in the canyon, and material that sinks out down from above. And that's the food source for benthic animals.
Kaikōura Canyon supports this amazingly rich deep sea ecosystem. That if there is a cycle of this sort of disturbance that fuels this system, it actually might be rich because every now and again you have these big impulses of organic matter. If you take a picture, you don't actually see that much in many places, but beneath that seafloor is a lot of life.
My experiments look at small organisms that live within the sediment, so the more active they are, the more oxygen they'll be using up. So the oxygen has been depleted really quickly, which just shows you how much biomass there is still living in the canyon even after the earthquake.
We very rarely have the chance to understand what a really catastrophic change on the seabed has on benthic ecology, this transfer of sediment to the deep ocean.
Amazingly, we're actually seeing signs of recovery. To begin to see some of those same animals in large numbers means that that is going to be able to support life as it used to in this particular area.